Digital ID is actually a challenge for billions of people around the world, because unlike in Western countries where when a child is born, a birth certificate is issued immediately and that becomes the root document for their life, in many parts of the world, birth registrations don't go so well. There are some states in India where more than half the babies are not registered at birth. So you have people growing up without any form of identity to say who they are. And today, every activity that you do, opening a bank account, getting into school, boarding a plane, they ask you for your ID. And therefore, lack of ID has become an impediment for the future of billions of people. And this has now become a very big global issue. In India, there's been a major move for what's called as financial inclusion, which is making sure that everybody is part of the formal financial system. And a basic requirement for that is to be able to open a bank account. And a basic requirement for a bank account is KYC, or know your customer, prove who you are. And thanks to Aadhaar ID system in India, in the last 5 years alone, 300 million new people have opened bank accounts. So, and now with those bank accounts, they can save money, they can receive benefits from the government, they can receive money remittances from their family members who have gone to the urban areas. So suddenly, you know, they're empowered with financial capability. Let me talk to you about Aadhaar, which is the Indian ID project. It's the world's largest ID system. About 1.2 billion Indians now have a digital ID. It all began exactly 10 years back when the government launched a project. In fact, it was in January 2009, 10 years ago. And they got approval to create an ID system because they wanted a way to both have inclusion as well as make benefit delivery more efficient. So I did a career switch. I resigned and retired from Infosys, joined the government for 4.5 years, and I worked with a great talented team of bureaucrats and technologists to build this ID platform. When I stepped down, 600 million people had the ID. And then there was an election, a new government came. They were also very enthusiastic, and they took it forward. So today, 1.2 billion people have an ID. 300 million people open bank accounts with it. It also runs the world's largest cash transfer program. So billions of dollars go electronically from government into somebody's bank account in real time. So these are all massive digital ways of amplifying people's opportunity.